Hello everyone, my name is Auro and welcome to the 5th devlog of my second game. Right off the bat, I have two very exciting things to share with you. First, my game has a name now. It will be called Chambers of Devious Design. I will talk a bit more about the name and the theme later in the video. And the second exciting thing I wanted to share with you, my game actually has a Steam page now. I made it public just now when I posted this video and I included the link in the description. Please check it out and tell me what you think. Personally, I am very happy how it turned out and of course I will add things there once I get closer to the release. Okay, with that out of the way, let me show you what I have done since the last devlog. First off, I got the idea that I could improve the current adjacency bonus color animation by adding a quick arrow animation on top of the rooms. I am going to include this as a GIF on the Steam page, so I wanted to make it even more clear what is happening when the walls are flashing with different colors. Speaking of GIFs, I was thinking that showcasing a special room on the Steam page would be a good idea. For that purpose, I created the Bomb Room. It's a room filled with all kinds of fun, explosive things. When blazed, it will destroy all adjacent enemy rooms. It works like a dream and I think this will be a very fun addition to the game. I also made a few icons I was thinking of using to showcase what some of the room UI windows might look like, but after making them, I figured it's not necessary for the Steam page, so I decided to skip making any mockups for now. Next, I wanted to add some kind of visuals for my available blocks section, so they aren't just floating around in the air. There's still an issue with the blocks going over the borders, but this looks clean enough for now. After that, I decided to improve the doorway graphics. Those thick green lines just won't do. Here, this should be better. It's a bit of a balancing effort to have something that looks very obvious to the player and that at the same time looks pleasing to the eye. I figured a light shining from the doorway effect like this would be a nice middle ground. I also added a smooth little fade to the doorway light so that it disappears when you either connect it with another doorway or block it altogether. I had noticed that often when I was testing the game, my PC fans started going crazy, acting like my processor was just 1 degree away from turning into molten lava. I realized this was most likely because Unity was trying to run my game as fast as it could. No matter how pretty my game was, I didn't need to run it at 300 FPS, so I capped it at 60. After that, I haven't heard the death screech from my fans anymore, so it seems like that did the trick. After that, I got back to improving the visuals and next on my list was the floor textures. I spent quite a bit of time browsing the internet to find around 50 different free textures, adjusting them and trying them out in the game. Many of them didn't make the cut, but there were maybe like 10 that I figured I could use in the game. The textures were nice, but I felt like the overall look still needed to be improved. I figured adding some dark gradient to the edges of the rooms could make the floor visuals a bit more interesting. I think it's definitely an improvement and looks pretty nice in action. It helps to bring some contrast and a little bit of life into the rooms. After some testing, I ended up making the gradient a bit darker and wider. What do you think? Which version do you prefer? Continuing with the visual theme, I thought the starting rooms looked too empty, just standing around there without any furniture. So I added these glowing crystals in them to make them look a bit more special and have something shiny to look at. I am not yet sure if they are here to stay. Maybe I will keep them and turn this game into a Dungeon Keeper copy. You might also notice that I added a few new rune types to have more variety and improve the visuals by showing different colors on the screen. I think visually the game is now ready to get some screenshots for the Steam page. Speaking of the Steam page, I also spent some time coming up with the game descriptions and getting them translated to 10 other languages. This time around, I decided to get most of the translations done by a machine. I'm sure there are some errors, but when I was testing DeepL.com with English to Finnish, the quality was surprisingly good and it only had a few very minor contextual errors. But hey, if you know another language and notice any errors on my Steam page, I would really appreciate if you let me know how to fix them. For the Asian versions, I still got manual translations, as I had a hunch that those would prove the most challenging for the machine, and at least with Mortal Glory, the Asian localizations proved to be the most valuable. I have a few videos about localizing Mortal Glory if you're interested in more details. When I had the descriptions and screenshots ready, I spent a good while creating the different capsule images for Steam. There are many different size images with different aspect ratios that you need to prepare for Steam, so it can be a time-consuming process if you are doing it yourself. The best way would be to get one single professional artist to do everything for you, the logo, the illustrations and the Steam images. But I feel like it's quite hard to find someone who can do it all well, and it can get very expensive. So I opted for a middle-of-the-road solution by getting the logo done by one artist, character illustrations done by another artist, and then I myself combined those and added some backgrounds for the Steam images. I am happy with what I was able to produce and they look good to my eye, but let me know if it's just me that thinks they look pretty. If you're curious, my process was basically just finding some free background images, playing with the colors, doing some light editing and seeing if they could add some interesting textures to the background. After that, my Steam page was now ready to get approved by Valve. I won't go deeper on the Steam page details in this video, but I am planning on making a few videos really soon on what the process looks like, everything you need to do, and also to give some tips on what you should focus on the most. And lastly, a few words about the name and the theme I chose. So the theme and the premise of the game will be that you are a henchman working for an evil mastermind who wants a new hideout, and he will have lots of peculiar demands for what kind of rooms the complex needs to have and so on. You will also be competing against other henchmen to see who can build the best hideout, and there will likely be other evil masterminds also making an appearance in the game. I had been thinking about this premise for over a month now, and there never really was any other strong contender for it. I don't think there actually really are that many options when you think about big, interesting building complexes. There are castles, but I didn't want to go for the same theme as the board game that inspired my game. Then there are palaces, mansions, and other big buildings like that, but I didn't think there were any that interesting themes connected to them that wouldn't need to be separately explained. I'm sure you could come up with some really creative themes that would also be fun to build around. But I decided to go with the building a hideout for an evil mastermind team, as I think it offers a lot of opportunities for some deviously creative rooms, some interesting characters, and opportunities also for introducing some humor to the game. As for the name, I chose the name after a joint brainstorming session with me and the wife. It was sort of a combination of different words we each came up with, and both of us thought that this was the best out of all the options, so it was a nice mutual effort. I was at first a bit worried since it's on the longer side, and most games these days seem to have very short names. But I think this name fits the theme very well, and it's a name that is just so fun to say. Chambers of Devious Design. The devious especially is such a nice melodic word, and when you combine it with design, there's a nice DD alliteration going on. But hey, what do you think about the name? Hopefully you don't hate it, because I will be repeating that name a lot. And that's where I will end this devlog. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.